To play. Now I need a Troublemakers Dozen, Deke Sharon here. I wish I could be with you in person in Nebraska, although it's kind of sunny here in California. Anyway, but I do wish I were there with you in person to hear your music and to work with you. Unfortunately, COVID, so as you know, we all need to stay separated, socially distanced, and I'm several states away. I think that's probably distant enough. Anyway, want to let you know, I checked out your videos and really enjoyed them. Let's talk a little bit about them. I want to make sure you know, even though I'm spending more time talking about issues and nitpicking or whatever, that doesn't mean I didn't enjoy them. I thought they were primo and fabulous. So let's talk a little bit about It's Alright first. I think you guys get the essence of the tune. And in fact, I like the body language that you had as you were singing the tune. Like, there was kind of like a casualness about you, a little bit of a laid back energy, which I think is just who you are. But that's why I think that song suits you really well. And I'm sure you've heard the original version of this by Huey Lewis in the News. It was on the radio. In fact, it was a radio hit. Such a fun, cool tune. Couple things though I think you should watch out for. Number one is the background parts, the do do boo, do do do. They live entirely in like an offbeat world, right? So you have to be feeling the downbeat so that they land in the right place. And it felt a little like you were singing the notes on the page, do 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 do, as opposed to do 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 do. And it's not even the duration of the note. It's kind of more of a feel thing. Basses, the boom, is a diphthong, right? Boom. It's almost three vowels, right? Oh, 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 right? You're going from the most open to closed, right? The problem is if you're singing that note and you're also changing the pitch, boom, boom, it ends up just kind of being this big kind of curvy mass rather than staying right on one note, boom, do, boom. Boom. And emphasizing the ah part of the bomb so the tone can really come through. Now, I realize if you were just one person on a microphone singing this as opposed to an entire group, you'd have a little more flexibility, but you got to standardize it so that and make choices so that the volume will really get through and cut through the whole group. So that's my overall thoughts about It's All Right. Little things that can help make the overall sound a little more solid. Now, when we get to Yesterday, I think this song is a little bit less who you guys are. Obviously, the Beatles, I mean, this song was written, like at this point, two generations ago. So it really feels like old-timey music, perhaps, to you. It is perhaps the most recorded song in all of popular music over the past 70 years, if not longer. So that in and of itself is, you know, a testament to its timelessness. Nonetheless, your body language seems to change a little bit with this song, and you know, I can tell you're thinking about or focusing on trying to get all the parts right, but the song really must have a sweetness to it that is about, you know, nostalgia and thinking about the past, but there should be a little bit of warmth and smile in the song as opposed to keeping it entirely heavy. Let me play a little bit of it. The video's right down here, by the way. If you see me looking down there, I'm not looking at a potted plant. All right, here we go. Now your tone right here is really nice. You guys sing nice pianos. You bring the volume back beautifully. And the add nine is nicely floated in there. And I like the way your phrases have a nice arch to them, which is really good. Maybe part of it is that, I'm glad you're moving and swaying with the song, but some of it feels a little more like nervous fidgeting than, like, actually really expressing the piece of music. It's hard to know if I'm right. I mean, you have masks on, like, two-thirds of your face is covered, so it's hard to get a sense of the body language, right? But the song wants to move in gentle, broad arcs, not kind of just moving back and forth. I don't know if I'm making much sense with that comment, but I want to make sure you guys know that when you're singing a ballad, it requires an emotional vulnerability and a real focus on the music. So you can't live in a place where you're thinking about other stuff, so that's the autopilot part, Or were you kind of like nervous about like, am I singing my note right? Is this pitch going to be right? You want to just let go of the conscious mind and get into the meaning of the notes in the music. Now, when you're rehearsing, you focus on all the mechanics of it. But when you end up actually making the music, you got to trust your instincts and then just dive in there. And you clearly know this music, which is great. You know the music and you're singing these chords really well. Like you've got nice lines and nice held notes or whatever. And your piano's like you can sing quietly well too. So I'm impressed with where this group is musically. And the last piece I think I would really just put on top of it is making sure that you're really thinking about the song, the lyrics of the song, what the song can mean to you while you're singing it, so then it can be transcendent. Then it can be more than just, we're a high school group singing this piece of music. You're a music group performing this piece of music. Anyway, hope these thoughts were helpful. And most of all, I hope we will all be together in person this time next year at Midland. Take care until then and stay safe.